West Aussies stuck in New South Wales could soon be locked out entirely as the state's COVID numbers surge. Infections hit more than 630 today, and their Premier warns the worst is yet to come.
Today's news written all over the face of the New South Wales Chief Health Officer.
I can't express enough my level of concern at these rising numbers of cases.
Sydney's cluster ballooning by a record 633 new infections in just 24 hours and tragically three more deaths, with fears of more to come.
So what the data is telling us in the last few days is that we haven't seen the worst of it.
WA is set to rush over medical help on top of 50 contact tracers already helping out.
A health team is going there and will be providing support, including at least one person to assist with that team going to Western New South Wales.
As he gets ready to pull the trigger on an extreme border, once New South Wales reaches a rolling average of 500 cases a day over at least 5 days. Today's numbers pushing it just shy of that mark that would end all compassionate grounds for entry.
The only people that can come in are defence officials, Commonwealth officials and federal members of parliament. The numbers coming in would be, you'd probably count them on one hand.
All required to do hotel quarantine. It comes as WA's finally struck a deal with the Commonwealth for a 1,000-bed quarantine facility to be built near Jandakot Airport in addition to our hotel quarantine.
The Commonwealth says work is expected to start within about 6 weeks. The demountables will be built off-site, speeding up the process, with about half to be ready by May next year.
I think that's probably optimistic, but we'll see what happens.
While the virus has also spread across the ditch, New Zealand's cluster has grown to 7, including a nurse at Auckland's biggest hospital. PM Jacinda Ardern clearly pointing the finger at New South Wales.
Our case has originated in Australia. And now the job we have is to work through how and when it got here.
As WA moves to tighten border restrictions with our Kiwi cousins.
Anyone arriving from New Zealand would be required to quarantine for 2 weeks and be tested.
While a mercy mission is underway to evacuate Aussies stranded in Indonesia, a Qantas flight left Denpasar this afternoon bound for Darwin with 200 Aussies on board.
I don't want to leave, but I can't get a vaccination in my own embassy.
Obviously me, it's medical and it's also to see my family.
I look forward to coming back when I can.
They'll spend 2 weeks in quarantine at Howard Springs. Natalie Forrest for 10 News First.